balance the equation, so we've got to basically take iron oxide plus aluminum to go to iron plus aluminum oxide. Aluminum oxide will be Al2O3. Aluminum is going to be plus 3, oxygen is always minus 2. That's 4 there. If we look at it and balance it, if we get 2 irons for every Fe2O3, and then we need 2 aluminums, and that balances the equation. So what we can do is go from grams Fe2O3 to moles Fe2O3 to mole Fe irons into grams iron. That'll give us our third yield. And then if we combine that into our actual yield, that will just get to the percentage yield. So what we're going to do is take our 50 grams of iron, divide that by 2 times 5.585 plus 3 times 16. It gives us 0.3109 mole of iron oxide. We multiply that by 2 moles of iron for every 1 mole of the oxide. 0.62618 mole of iron. We get the mass of this now. It's going to multiply by 55.85 grams per mole. That gives us then 34.97 grams of iron. So what we're going to do is take out 28.65 grams. Multiply 34.97 grams, multiply by 100%, that gives us 81.92%, yeah, which is pretty close to that. As I said, as I stand thinking about it, what you can probably actually do to get the theoretical yield of iron more quickly is to just basically multiply 50 grams by the ratio of mass of iron oxide to iron, which I think will be a little bit faster, but not overwhelmingly faster.